What's up, guys? Max here. I am thrilled. There is no other word. I am thrilled about this video. We're going to talk about Ripple and why it's going to surge. And I want you to listen because this is insane. We're going to talk about xRapid, the JPMorgan competition, Swell, the conference, the annual conference of Ripple, the SEC, whether they're going to accept it as a security or not, and we hope not. And the financial institutions coming into the market. Guys, all of this is huge and it's going to happen all in once. So you have to listen to this. I'm going to split this video in separate parts so that it's easier for me to shot and for you to digest, right? I know it's been a long time, we haven't done any video. We figured we had to take a step back and think about this channel and what we should do to bring you the most value. And actually, we figured that we actually had to speak about what interests us the most, which is actually Ripple and XRP, because it is the best digital asset. So here we are. So first things first, I am not a financial advisor. This is for entertainment purposes only, all right? Don't take anything that I say for the truth, because I would probably say that Ripple and XRP are going to be a huge thing, but this is not for sure, right? I'm just giving my opinion here. I'm trying to be as honest and realistic as possible, but I may be wrong. So right away, let's talk about RippleNet, right? So the strategy of Ripple is to actually build RippleNet, a network for financial institutions to transact, right? To message each other, to transact and to have transparency all the way through and low costs. As any network, the more you have people on this network, or institutions in that case, the more valuable is the network. So what it means here is that the more Ripple we have partnerships, the more it will be valuable and others will want to join Ripple and RippleNet. And today, Ripple have actually about 160 announced partnerships. I actually have them here, you can check it, rppl.info, and you have all the partnerships and what they are actually using. Xcurrent, are they testing it, using it? Are they testing xRapid? So about xRapid now, it's going to be launched in October, so real soon. Guys, I cannot stress it enough, this is absolutely insane. This is the first actual use case that has the potential to change everything financially for banks and for us as well. So this is probably the most important thing that is going to happen in cryptocurrencies this year, at least this year. And it's going to happen this month. Why am I saying this? As soon as XRP is launched, as you can see on my screen right now, some institutions are already going to use it straight away. Mercury FX is going to use it. It's a payment provider for international payments. And SBI virtual currencies. SBI is one of the largest banks in Japan. Then we also have less significant organizations, Qualix and ZipRemit. But those two up there are huge, and it's only the beginning. So what's going to happen when they launch xRapid? Well, they are going to start using it, and by using it, they will use XRP, of course, and by using XRP, it will increase, like multiply by dozens, the daily traded volume of XRP. And since they're using it, it will increase the price. But not only that, but the actual announcement by its own, since it's one of the biggest events that are going to happen, it's going to drive the price of XRP and the other cryptocurrency are going to follow up. Besides, since it's one major event, we're going to talk about it a lot. The community is going to go insane, and we're going to be able to read different articles about xRapid and XRP. This will drive hype, just as for the first bubble, the Bitcoin bubble. And with hype comes FOMO, because the price is going up, constantly up, and people don't want to miss out on this opportunity. This will increase even more the price. Guys, this is only my opinion, but on a logical way of thinking, I truly think this is what's going to happen. And guys, I'm talking a lot about the price, but believe me, xRapid in itself is a huge progress for Ripple. Probably the biggest event that is going to, the biggest release by Ripple that is going to happen. And we'll be able to truly see if Ripple is good at what they're doing. Now guys, the eulogy is done for me. And we're going to talk about the competition now. About 2 days ago, JPMorgan announced that they were creating a blockchain-based cross-border payment system. What does this mean? Ripple's main use case is cross-border payments, right? So is this competition or not? Well, yes it is, of course. They're using the Ethereum blockchain, but actually no digital asset. Which means that they're kind of using xCurrent. They are probably increasing the transparency and decreasing the costs. And it's going to be faster for sure. But they're not at the same level as xRapid, and probably not xCurrent, because Ripple has a lot of experience. They've been creating this system for the last 5 years. So it's hard to imagine that in 11 months, JPMorgan came out with a better solution. Even though they're using Ether, which is a digital asset, Ether is not nearly as good as XRP, right? It's about 16 transactions per second. It's not scalable. XRP can do up to 50,000 transactions per second, just as Visa can. Even concerning the price and the speed, XRP is far better. Just check the statistics. To see something happening in this field, that Ripple is not the only company doing something to improve their system, the bank system, the transactions that are happening all over the world. What does this mean to you? But to me, and not only to me, it seems that it's a confirmation that we are on good track. The things they're trying to do, Ripple, trying to solve all these remittances problems, the liquidity problems, they're solving a $27 trillion problem. Guys, this means if there is some competition, this means that it is actually possible and that it is important. There is a lot of money to be made here. And the more money there is to be made, the more money will flow through XRP. And the better it is for us. This is what I wanted to talk about today. We're going to do another episode in about 2 or 3 days from now. I'm going to talk about the SEC and the new institutions, the new investors coming in. Be ready, because next days are going to be awesome for us. I truly believe that. Again, I'm not your financial advisor. Do your own thing, your own research, and I'll see you in the next one.